Hi everyone, welcome to the first Grain PhD webinar. Tonight we're going to focus on how to use GrainBridge, a farm management software provided free to all Grain PhD customers. My name is Tim Smith. I'm an agri-risk specialist with Grain PhD. I primarily work with producers, helping them manage price risk through the use of futures and options, as well as manage marketing programs. Tonight, I also have with me GrainBridge specialist, Brittany Seda, and producer and user of the GrainBridge software, Patrick. Brittany's an account manager with GrainBridge. She's been working with clients to set up and best utilize their accounts for managing their grain and livestock operations. And for this webinar, she'll be navigating the software and answering your questions along the way. Patrick is a corn and bean farmer from Nebraska. He stores most of his crop, markets to commercial grain elevators. During this webinar, Patrick would like to organize a budget and create a marketing plan for the upcoming year. As you can see on your screen this evening, we're going to focus on a few key areas: how to update your GrainBridge information, marketing strategies, how to use GrainBridge reports, how to easily start a 2019 marketing plan, and then we'll open the webinar for a few of your questions. Now, during the webinar, everyone will be on mute, so if you'd like to ask a question, please look in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. There's an orange arrow. If you click that arrow, it's going to expand a box. Please use the chat section of that box to submit any questions you may have. We'll try to cover all your questions by the end of this presentation. If you do have a specific marketing question for your operation, please submit them as well, and I'll follow up with you individually this week. In addition, just above the chat comments section, there's a Grain PhD and GrainBridge handout. If you're new to GrainBridge or Grain PhD, I recommend that you take a look at that at some point during this presentation. Now, throughout the webinar, we're going to ask participants to answer just a couple polls. The current poll on the screen will help us direct the webinar to your interests, as well as follow up post-webinar appropriately. To answer, simply make your selection by clicking the items you're most interested in. Now, there may be a lot of you that have not had an opportunity to learn about GrainBridge and how the software can help you as producers better manage your farm operation. Brittany, would you mind giving a brief overview of what GrainBridge is and some of its key features before we dive in?
Absolutely. So before we jump into Pat's account, I'll give you a chance to answer that poll question on the screen. And while you're doing that, I'll just kind of give you a background on what GrainBridge is. So GrainBridge is a web-based comprehensive risk management software that brings together the financial aspects of your business so that you always know where you are when it comes to profitability. So in GrainBridge, you can build a production and marketing plan for crops and livestock. You can manage your cash, futures, and options trades, track your farm's profitability each day with the market price updated daily, and you can generate clean, customized reports. So today, we'll use Pat's account to show you these features as we update his 2018 account and prepare him for 2019. So he set up his account for 2018 with Tim's help last winter, and he's been coming back periodically over the year to make updates when needed. So now that harvest is over, we want to be sure that everything is up to date in Pat's account. So with that, I am going to go ahead and close the poll, and we'll jump right into GrainBridge. Okay, so now you all should be seeing Pat's farm account in GrainBridge. And Pat, if you're ready for me, we're going to start with updating a few different items in your account. So as you can see, Pat's farm account is already populated. As I mentioned, he's worked with Tim to get to this point. So every time now when he logs in, he's able to see a summary of his operation on this account. And we are going to work through the different pages of his GrainBridge account. So these top tabs that are in blue, that's where we're going to work through today. So let's start in the profile sections. The profiles are where Pat has provided basically an electronic version of what his operation looks like. So for Pat, he has corn and beans. So he has two profiles here, one for corn and then one for beans. So Pat, let's revisit those yields now that harvest is over and make sure that those are accurate. When you first set up your account, you had estimated 175 bushels per acre for your dry land and then 200 bushels per acre for irrigated. So are there any changes that we need to make to those yield numbers?
Yeah, actually on the corn, we did just total everything up over the weekend, and we do need to make some adjustments on the dry land corn. We need to up that right at about 10 bushels to 185 on our final yields.
Okay, great. So to update the yield, you just click in this yield box where we had 175, and I am just going to type in 185. And for irrigated, did you have any changes there?
Yeah, we'll be at just right at 220 bushels for an average.
Okay. Great. So it's really as simple as that. So we've just updated the yields, and now once we hit the green save crop profile at the bottom of the page, that will update our yield so we have the right amount of bushels that you'll be working to market with Tim. So that's why we want to make sure that your yields are accurate. Let's take a look at your bean number. So we'll click this view button to the right and make sure that those yields are up to date. So we have a yield of 50 bushels per acre on dry land and 70 on irrigated. Are those numbers accurate for you, Pat?
Yeah, that is. Unfortunately, we were hoping for a little better on our dry land, but we had a little bit of stress on a couple fields. So I think we'll leave everything alone and leave it as is for the beans for now.
Okay, sounds great. So we will just hit this back button to go back to those profiles. So that is really all we needed to do to update your profile section. The next section we want to work through in updating is the plan. So that's up at the top in that lineup of tabs. And this is where you built your budget with Tim back last winter. And I'm sure you've come back in here periodically to make changes to some of those expenses, especially during planting, and if you had any chemical changes, those sorts of things. But now, as harvest has gotten rolling, I'm sure it's been a little while since you've revisited this. So let's take a quick look at your expenses and make sure that these are all up to date. Did you have anything this harvest that was unexpected that we need to add here?
You know, I looked through this briefly the last couple days before this meeting, and I think we're in pretty good shape here. I do have a couple expenses that we weren't expecting that I haven't updated on the gross fixed cost. So we could go to that section if you want, Brittany.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go over to your gross expenses. Okay. So what on this page should we change?
Yeah, the first item that we plugged in that we didn't itemize out initially, and just hopefully this is where we'll end up. But I spent about $4,500 on propane for drying costs. So if we can add that in the utilities or in a custom field, that'd be great.
Sure. Yeah, so that we can keep it separate for you so that you can come back here and know exactly what you paid for propane. And that it was specifically for your dryer. We're actually going to come down to the bottom of this page to the Add and Manage Custom Expenses button that's in blue. This allows you to customize expenses however it fits best for your operation. So like I said, this will help you keep it straight when you come back in here, so it's not grouped with anything else.
Okay, great. That'll be nice.
Once we hit Save, we will go back with this back button to your list of expenses. And then if you scroll down to the bottom, we now have this field that we just created. So it's really simple to add those custom expenses. And you said that was $4,500, right?
Yes, right, $4,500.
Okay. Great. And notice as I change these, your break-even numbers for corn and soybeans are changing immediately as I change that number. So as we make changes, you know right away how that impacts your break-even. So just something to take note of.
Oh, that's nice.
All right.
Brittany, that's kind of interesting. I see down at the bottom for that, it automatically splits it out for corn and beans 60-40, and that's about what my split in my corn and bean rotation is.
Yeah, that's a great point to note. So the system will automatically allocate the expense based on the number of acres in each profile. So since you have 40% of your acres in soybeans and 60 in corn, it'll automatically allocate the cost that way, but you can change this. So if you had all of your drying expense allocated to corn, you can actually click on this drop down. Yep. And then assign a percentage. So if you'd rather have 100% of that expense go to corn, you can type that custom percentage there and hit save. So that's a good point on bringing that up. So it makes it extra customizable for you. All right. Are there any other expenses you see that we need to update?
Yeah, I did make a note. We had last minute here on finishing up harvest. We got had some folks come out and help us just to finish up a couple quarters. And so we had a little additional hired labor, and right at about $18,000 in an additional cost. So we need to add that in.
Okay. So rather than the 24 you were expecting, we've got $42,000 instead.
Right.
All right. How does that look for you, Pat? Do you have everything you think you had this harvest accounted for?
Yeah, I think so. I think that was the other item that I had made note of last week, and so I think we're good to go.
Now, Pat, I see you do have $50,000 in repairs already input into the software. Maybe you already added this, but I remember in one of our past conversations, you mentioned you had a little hiccup during harvest with a breakdown. Did you happen to come into the software and update that already?
Oh, you know what? I don't believe I did. Actually, yeah, we did have a little ding to the unloading auger and had a couple repairs there. So let me look here. I don't have any notes that I actually added that. So that's a good catch. We better add to it another $10,000, Brittany, if you could.
Sure.
Add $10,000 to that. Thanks, Tim. That's a good reminder. I kind of forgot about that one.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, Tim. So I think with that, as long as everything looks up to date to you both, I think Pat's Grainbridge account is up to date. Break evens are good. So let's take a look at his cash sales and brokerage positions, and you can walk through the marketing segment.
Great. I took a look at the Grainbridge software, and Brittany's pulling it up right now. I noticed that you were in the neighborhood of 40 to 50% sold, Pat. So based on our previous conversations, you do have some on-farm storage remaining. Is that correct?
You know, we are at this point in time, we're now, as we've just finished up this weekend, we did build in some short-term storage and bagged a couple quarters, but we are going to have some overrun that we just finished delivering today, about 20,000 bushels. So
okay.
Unfortunately, we had maybe it was a good thing, actually. We did have an extra $20,000 that we did have to deliver to town.
Okay. Well, with that, I would recommend storing the maximum remaining bushels that you can, and wait for some better opportunities, whether that comes with this week's USDA report or a little later down the road. Some price targets that I'd keep in mind, and that my hedge team has some sale targets at, are $3.95, $4, and $4.05. Those are based off the March 19 futures contract. I will say you can also keep in mind that if you do have some concerns that corn values could retest some of those September lows, Pat, there are some strategies we could discuss that would allow you to protect these bushels and it put a floor in just above that break even that we just updated around 358. Now, for the overrun bushels, the ones that you just delivered to the elevator, I believe you said it was about 20,000 bushels. You have a few options. I'd consider making a cash sale at 370 and then re-owning those bushels. You can do that through one of the following. One being just buying March 19 futures at 380. Now, what that would do for you is that would replace your physical grain ownership with ownership on paper. The main difference being that there is margin risk on a long futures position. So if values do decline, you would be required to provide some additional margin funds to hold that position.
Okay.
If you would like a little less risk revolved around the position, you could buy a March 19 corn, a 390 call. Those are about 10 cents right now. And then your risk is limited to just that premium you pay, just that 10 cents. There's no margin risk if prices decline. Then the strategy allows you to avoid some high storage costs, allows you to generate some cash flow on your operation and still participate in a rise in value. In addition to that, it creates a minimum price contract when tied to your cash sale. And that minimum price would be 360 in this case. So that locks in a floor just above that new cost of production that we just calculated, 358. So I believe in some of our conversations that you've used minimum price contracts through your elevator. So you're familiar with this type of strategy. Is that right?
Yeah, we've done on and off. We've done some of the different programs that our local elevators offered, and minimum price is something we're familiar with. We've done that before, so.
Okay, well, and you can certainly still do the minimum price contract through your local elevator. A nice feature that some producers have liked in the past about that is that the elevator tracks that position for you. With GrainBridge, you can track it yourself very easily. And in most cases, it's going to be done at a lower cost by using your own hedge account through GrainPhd. And that's about a penny a bushel is what that cost comes to. And then it allows you some more flexibility as well with your cash sale.
Okay. Yeah, that, you know, I like that option versus maybe just going out and directly buying the futures. Maybe having a maximum cost of the 10 cents. That sounds good to me. I think we ought to do something like that.
Okay, good. I think that's a good decision for your operation. I do want to ask if Brittany could show us how to add that trade to GrainBridge and then tie it back to his cash sale that he made at the elevator at 370.
Yeah, sure, Tim. So let's walk through GrainBridge to add those bot calls. So we're going to go to the brokerage section, which this is a tab on that top menu, and we will select options from the dropdown. So what we're going to add here in the brokerage section of GrainBridge is not actually making the trade, This is just where you organize your trades is what GrainBridge is. So this isn't a trading platform. You'll still have to put the trade on through your account with Tim, but at least you're able to manage it here and organize it in an easy to understand format. So we'll use this green button. The green buttons really lead you through the system as far as adding different things and making changes. So we'll select add options trade and we're buying a call. Since this is for our corn, we're going to select our corn profile. And we'll have four contracts to match up with our 20,000 bushels that we sold in cash. Contract month is March of 19. Strike price is $3.90. And this is costing 10 cents. And the fee we enter on a per side basis, so it's $24.50 per side. So we just follow the form, and then once you have the completed sections entered, we'll use that green add options trade button. So now in the system, you can see that we have those bought calls entered to keep track of. So each day this gain or loss will be calculated. We'll pull in the market price and give a value to that position. So let's go back over to the cash sales section. This is where we're going to link your brokerage trade for the calls to your existing cash sale. So as Tim mentioned, this will help you see it like it would be at your local elevator as far as being similar to a minimum price contractor that they would do with you. So this 20,000 bushel contract right here is the one that we want to attach those trades to. So to do that, we're going to click the view button on the right. And we'll utilize the attach brokerage trades button in the brokerage section. So what this allows you to do is choose from any of the open positions that you have on. So you have a few other futures and options positions, but what we want to find are those bought calls. So right here, we're going to do all four contracts so that we have 20,000 bushels accounted for, and then we'll hit that attach brokerage trades button once again. And now this summary section is what is really helpful for you to see where this cash contract is at each and every day. So you can see where the original cash sale was made at that 370 price. And then each day there will be the gain or loss calculated on those bought calls, giving you a total cash value on that contract. So this makes it really simple to see what that cash contract is valued at when you can attach those brokerage trades.
Wow, that is nice. That I always have to have that discussion with Tim, and we got to pull up my account and see where it's at, but this kind of puts it all together. So I like that. Okay.
Yeah, and you can you can automatically feed in futures positions as well to the system, so you don't have to manually add those as well, Pat. So that may be something we look at down the road.
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. If we can, anything we can get away from manual entry, I'm all for it. That sounds good. Okay. Well, good. Yeah, I think that looks good. I appreciate you guys helping me walk through that and showing me some of those little pointers. With that, I feel pretty good about where we're at.
Fantastic. So now that Tim and Pat had a chance to discuss marketing strategies specific to Pat's situation, I am going to present another poll. So these were customized to Pat's specific operation. So if you would like the opportunity to talk with Tim about marketing strategies that are specific to your operation, I'm going to give you about 20, 30 seconds. You can submit your answers on the poll that's up on the screen right here.
Tim, I don't think I'll answer the poll, but I'll just tell you flat out, I'm not going to call you. I'm going to have you call me.
Well, and the nice thing about during these conversations is we don't just go through your operation. I'd be happy to help you set up your GrainBridge profile, the initial profile if you're a new user to it as well.
Yeah, that's helpful. I know you have some videos that kind of walk through how to get started, but having you guys kind of help me through this the first time, that is kind of nice. So Brittany, I'm curious, and maybe you're gonna get into this in a little bit, but I'm starting to think about now that it's getting cold and it's been raining, and it looks like we're gonna have snow this week. I'm gonna probably sit down and start working on some plans for next year. Do I gotta take the time to go through that whole planning process again and field by field, or is there some way that you can automate that?
That's a great question. So yeah, we can walk through that for you, Pat. So it can definitely be overwhelming to sit down and plan for each year, but one of the great parts about GrainBridge is that there are some easy ways to copy over things that you did in 2018 when you originally set up your GrainBridge account, so that starting 2019 is a whole lot easier. So we're going to start with that blue change button next to the 2019 at the top of the page. So this will allow us to shift over to 2019 and get you a jump start on setting up your account for next year. So we'll hit the green go button.
Okay.
So this is what your screen looked like this year when you first originally came into GrainBridge. So as you mentioned, there are some videos that walk you through it, but now that you have information from 2018, this will go a lot faster. So we'll start with the green add crop button since you have corn and soybeans. Instead of choosing the top option, which is add crops, we're actually going to choose to copy existing crops from other production years. So in this dropdown, you'll see an option for your 2018 production. Had you set up anything in past years, you also have the option to go back to those. So if you had anything in 2017, for instance, that would also show up as an option to copy over into 2019. So we'll choose 2018 and then hit copy. Okay, so now you can see all the data from 2018 has been pulled in. So this is what we have to select from for your starting out 2019. So I'm gonna guess that you're gonna wanna bring in both corn and soybeans, but do the acres and yield numbers for both of those look like what you wanna have at least start with for next year?
Yeah, I think that's good. We'll probably leave it about the same. Our rotation won't change a whole lot. We'll probably be 60% corn and 40% beans again, just switching some acres around. So, and the yields, I'm good with starting there. That's a pretty realistic place for me to start.
Okay, great. So you can always come back in here and edit it throughout the year if you do make any changes when it comes down to choosing what you want to plant. But for now, we're just going to choose the green copy crop profiles. And now you've got your corn and soybeans entered into the system for 2019, as simple as that.
Ah, okay, that's nice.
Yeah. So the other area that we have a copy function available for you to make it a little easier is back in that plan section. So this is the budgeting area of GrainBridge. So I'll choose that tab at the top. So since you spent so much time last year planning out that budget, and that's where we just made edits to as far as updating for harvest expenses, the nice thing about this is we have a button that says copy data from existing plan. So I'm going to click that. And this gives us the opportunity to pull in those expenses from last year. And then from there, you can just make any alterations you need to if things change for 2019. So in this dropdown, once again, since you have just 2018 set up, that's the only year we have to choose from. But as you progress and use this year over year, you'll have every year that you use GrainBridge as an option. So the next step is for each profile we copied over, both corn and soybeans, we have to choose which profile from last year to copy into 2019. So we'll just go soybeans to soybeans and corn to corn. And then again, we'll use the green copy plan button. If we go over to expenses per acre,
don't tell me I don't have. Oh my! Wow, Brittany, that's going to be handy. Great.
Yeah, it definitely.
I'm glad I don't have to start from scratch. Yeah, that's nice. Okay. Great.
Absolutely.
My wife's going to like that. I was going to have her sit down and start breaking this all out, but. I won't worry about it now.
Right.
Very good. Yeah, everything looks like it did from last year. And then I can go in and make edits and modifications as some things change, right?
Yep, any of these boxes are editable fields. So if you need to change your seed expense, for instance, for beans, if it isn't 50 this year for dryland, maybe it's 52, you can just make those changes right on the screen. But this at least gives
you a
good starting point. So as you work with Tim, you'll have a good quick start to establishing your break even so that when you make those marketing decisions for 2019, you have a good idea of where your break even is.
Yeah, okay. All right, great. Well, thanks, Brittany. Tim, just thinking about this now, I have not thought at all about marketing for 2019 with everything we've been doing the last couple months, but what's your thoughts on 2019 at this point? Any specific targets or percentages you think we need to start looking at?
Yeah, Pat, my hedge team has put together a few sale targets. Right now, we've actually begun making sales in new crop corn. The levels we're looking at are starting at 405 based on these 19 futures, and then we have additional targets up to the 420 level, about every 5 cents making a small sale. With bean targets being around 925 and 3/4 as a starting point based on November 19. And then we have additional sale targets in the same fashion as scale in approach up to that 960 level. For your operation, I'd recommend getting about 40% sold in between these initial price targets that we just said. But keep in mind, Pat, that a good marketing plan, it is flexible. It's not a static plan. So now that you're working with Grain PhD, an agri-risk specialist like myself or myself will stay in contact with you. And we review your marketing plan on a regular basis, and we'll make adjustments when we feel they're necessary.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. I'm going to be busy doing some field work here if the weather allows, and I might need you to prod me a little bit if you start seeing some opportunities, because I may not be paying attention. So, okay.
Yeah, and we'll try to get some targets in place before the USDA report, given a lot of analysts feel that could be a friendly surprise.
Yeah, okay. That sounds good. All right, very good. You know, the other thing, my wife and I are starting to put together, and this plan's going to help. We got to start preparing for our renewal meeting with the bank. Anything you guys recommend from a financial perspective within the Grainbridge software that can help us kind of prepare for that meeting?
Absolutely. Yeah, let's go look at the report. So I'm going to go back over to 2018 since we moved over to your 2019. And then we'll show you a couple of reports that are really nice to bring into the meeting with your lender. So Grainbridge has a few different reports that are really helpful. We'll start with the plan report. So we'll run the report with this green button again. And the plan report summarizes everything we entered in that plan section, which is your budgeting section. So we break it out into different cards that summarize. So in this top one, you have a summary of your break-even, target price. And then if you scroll down, you'll see all of those per acre expenses and then totals for both dry land and irrigated for both commodities that you have. If you had livestock, this would also be in here as well. And then we break it out to your gross farm expenses and then any profit goals that you have entered as well. So this is a great report to run and bring to your lender. You can export it directly from here or email it directly to your lender if you'd like to do that as well.
Ah, that'll be nice. Okay, great. Well, that'll give them a start for what we need for our cash flow and balance sheet then, I think. Great. All right.
Yeah. Yeah, so the second report I'll show you is the risk management report. So all of these are found in the reports tab at the top. And once you click on risk management, we'll look at it for 2018, excuse me. So this risk management report is very comprehensive and provides a good visual and summary of exactly where you are in relation to current markets. So in this revenue summary, you can see what percentage hedged you are for each one, which a lender likes to look at. This breaks it down in a more easily understandable form for them as far as giving a current revenue value, target revenue. And this will update daily, as I said, with the markets being pulled in each and every day. So you get a good look at where you are for each commodity. So we break it down right here. You're looking at your corn. And this shows you any cash sales, any brokerage positions you have in a very organized fashion that's easy for anyone to understand. And there you can see the futures and options. So those bought calls that you put on with Tim, those are listed right here as well. And when you scroll down, you get into your beans. So it breaks it down in a really nice format. And this too is available to export or to email with these top buttons at the very top of the report.
Yeah, I can see with the tight margins that we're faced with right now, this is going to be a nice report that I can just email them. Or Tim, maybe you could even email this to the bank on a quarterly basis as they're hitting on us a little more to give them an update on what we're doing for marketing. And I know they're a little stressed with managing these margin accounts as well, but this might be an easier way to give them a visual of what we're doing.
Yeah, it's a very simple way. I can certainly take care of that for you.
Okay. All right, that looks great.
All right, well, all right. We do have some time for a few questions. Now to ask a question, it's going to be the same way that you could throughout the webinar. In the upper right-hand side, if you haven't already clicked the orange arrow, you can click it now, and that'll expand your box. And within that box, there's this section titled Chat. Just type your question in that box and submit it. Only the meeting organizers will see those questions. Again, if you do have a specific marketing question for your operation, please still submit them, but I will follow up with you individually this week to discuss your question and your operation. If your question is not answered, please don't worry. We will follow up with anyone who submits a question after the webinar. While these questions are being asked, there will be two more polls. Please take a moment and answer these as well.
All right, so I see one question that got submitted. We have one asking that if I start using Grainbridge now, will everything change in a few months with the Cargill ADM joint venture with Grainbridge, or is the functionality the same? So I will go ahead and answer that. It is all going to stay the same. So don't worry about starting to use it now and having it go to the wayside. There isn't a date or anything that there's any plan for Grainbridge to go away. So no worries if you start using it. There's no concern to be had about the system leaving. So you can be confident that it will be here for you to use just in the same functionality that it exists today. We have a second question. This one has to do with what Grainbridge does with data, and can you cover data privacy? So everyone, when they sign up for a Grainbridge account, actually signs the data privacy agreement. So we do not share your data. We actually, even when we help you on our support line, we have to have you provide us access to view your account as well. So we take data privacy very seriously. We have bank level security on your data, so you can feel confident that it is safe in the system. Okay, next question we have is how you enter data, similar to rent or things that vary per farm. So the example is that some farms are cash rented at different levels and other crops are shared. So Grainbridge is really customizable whether you want to manage it per farm or by commodity. So let me just switch over on Pat's account. I'll close this poll we have going so I can show you what I mean by that. So you can manage it by individual field. So in the profile section is where you would make that decision. So in Pat's case, we organized it by corn and soybeans. So we did it by commodity and totaled all of the acres. An option you have here is to add a profile for each individual field. So in that case, then you would be able to make decisions on a field by field level. So the easiest way to do that is when you choose to add a crop, there's a description field here. So you could put your field name there, and then you would just choose the acres on that field. So you would have more than just the one profile for corn. And then that way in your budgeting section, you can choose to enter your budget by field if you'd like.
Looks like we have another question. Can you suggest specific resource to learn very basics of grain marketing, puts, calls, for some people new to using futures and options? GrainPhD.com is a great resource. We have a very robust educational section that you can pull just that data. You can pull data on how to use puts, how to use calls, and get the definitions of each one of those. Also, when you contact an agorist specialist, he can provide you with all this data as well.
And then the next question I see is, does the production and marketing data integrate into the balance sheet? So it does not. The balance sheet and cash flow statements, the data that you have in the plan section does not go in there automatically. So those are areas where you do have to enter in the values that you want to get started in the balance sheet or the cash flow statement. One other question I see that came in here is, if I want to test a specific sales strategy, is there a way to do this in your system and see how it impacts my profitability? So that is a great question. And as we were looking at the reports, you'll notice that there are a couple other options. The matrix report actually allows you to run what-if scenarios and stress test your operation. So if we click on, let's go with 2018 corn for Pat, we'll change our price increment to 50 cents. So there's an option to turn on a marketing strategy on this as well. So if you want to test out how making a cash sale today or putting on a futures or options position impacts your operation, you can do that here as well, but let's run it without the marketing strategy just to show you what the report looks like without testing a strategy out. So this report can show you with a price or a yield change how your profitability will be impacted. So the bold number in the center that's in the green at $26.09 is what you'd be making per acre with a yield that we have as your average of 204, and then the current market price at 386, less the basis that we have in the system. So right now, when you hover over any of these, you can see how that price is, how that profitability is being calculated. So we show you your sold value of your sold positions as well as your unsold bushels. And you can see where you'd be making money, what that risk, if the price were to fall or if your yield were to fall. This makes it really simple to see how a price change or a yield change affects your operation.
Brittany, this is Pat. Just sitting here thinking as some of these questions come up, and this is something that Julie and I have kind of thought about in our initial steps of building this out, but are you guys, you are starting to automate once you've populated the data to pre-populate it for the next year, but is there anything you guys are looking at in the future to pre-populate any of the data?
So right now, those are our options for pre-populating. But there is the ability to also pull in any brokerage trades and import those into your account automatically as well. So that takes out some of the manual entry as far as that goes. So like with the call situation that you did with Tim earlier, that can be imported if your brokerage account is connected to your GrainBridge account so that you don't have to manually enter those trades.
Okay, nice.
Well, I wanted to thank everyone for joining us on our first Grain PhD webinar featuring the farm management software GrainBridge. Now, keep in mind, everyone's farm operation and risk tolerances are different. So the examples that we gave this evening are very basic strategies that work for Pat and his personal goals. It may or may not be in the best interest for your particular operation. I do encourage you to visit grainphd.com to learn more about our services, view our educational material, and if you have questions, please use our Ask an Expert tool or just give us a call at 844-GRAIN-01. Agri specialists like myself would enjoy the opportunity to speak with you and drill down a strategy that best fits your personal operation. We look forward to helping you improve your grain marketing. Thanks again for joining us and have a great evening.